Welcome to TechSmart's Clean Room Training video. Today, we'll be covering topics ranging from general clean room information to TechSmart's specific gowning procedure. Let's begin. Before entering the clean room, it's important to know the separate types of classifications that can define a clean room. The ISO classification system is one way in which clean rooms can be defined. Every clean room is defined in ISO class based on the number of particles in the air. A clean room with an ISO class of 1 would be allowed only 10 micrometer-sized particles in the room at all times. An ISO class 2 would allow 100 micrometer-sized particles. An ISO class 3 would allow 1,000, and so on. Biosafety levels are a different type of classification used, which help to define the type of protection required when handling the wide array of chemicals used within the cleanroom. Chemicals with a biosafety level 1 require a basic level of protection and are appropriate for agents that are not known to cause disease in normal, healthy humans. Chemicals with a biosafety level 2 require protection appropriate for handling moderate risk agents that cause human disease of varying severity by ingestion or through percutaneous or mucous membrane exposure. Chemicals with a biosafety level 3 require a level of protection appropriate for agents of indigenous or exotic origin, which may cause serious and potentially lethal infections after inhalation. Lastly, chemicals with a biosafety level 4 require the highest level of protection appropriate for exotic agents that pose a high individual risk of life-threatening disease caused by infectious aerosols and for which no treatment is available. Yikes. Now that we've gone over some of the basic facts about the clean room, it's time to start gowning up. Before we start gowning up, however, there's some very important points to keep in mind. For one, no food or drink is allowed at all into the clean room. Two, no running or horseplay is allowed in the clean room. Three, keep all garments on while looking in the clean room. Four, all jewelry must be removed before gowning up. Five, do not bring any tools or materials from inside the clean room outside of it. And lastly, six, no personal belongings, for example, wallets, cell phones, etc., are allowed in the clean room. Your first step is to put on your hairnet. Make sure it covers all of your hair and also covers your ears. Next, you'll have to put on your face mask. Be sure the straps on the face mask get tucked underneath the hairnet. Make sure your face mask covers from the top of your nose to the bottom of your chin, and be sure to pinch the top of the mask across the nose once it's on. Next, it's time to put on the blue foot covers. Slip the foot covers over your shoes and make sure they cover the entire shoe, including the shoelaces. Next, it's time to put on the white jumpsuit. Push your legs through the leg holes. And then push your arms through the armholes. Zipper it up. Next, let's put on our white booties. Slip these on over the blue shoe covers, and make sure the legs and the white jumpsuit get tucked into the booties. It's time to put our gloves on now. All gloves are located in the storage cabinet on the left of the door when you enter into the gowning room. Find the gloves which correspond to your hand size, and put them on. Make sure you tuck your jumpsuit sleeves into the gloves when you put them on. Lastly, we have to put on our safety goggles. The last thing we want to do is expose our eyes to some of the dangerous chemicals used inside the clean room. Grab a pair out of the box and open them up out of the plastic wrapping. When you put them on, make sure you tuck them into your hairnet. Congrats, you're all gowned up, and it's time to have a long, productive day in the clean room. When you're done, we'll teach you how to degown. Boy golly, that sure was a productive day. It's time to degown now. First, we'll start with the gloves. If your hands came into contact with any chemicals in the clean room, try to be careful while taking them off. You don't want your skin exposed to them. Next, take off your hairnet and throw it into the garbage can. Then your face mask. After that, take care of your booties and blue shoe covers. Once you're done with those, unzip your white jumpsuit and throw that out as well. Lastly, take off your safety goggles and return them to their box. Congratulations, you're ready to start working in the clean room. Remember, if you see someone out struggling, try and help them out. Remember, follow our advice, stay safe, and let's do some science.